Transmission begins.
5, 4, 3, 2, 1.
This is the Josh Tolley Show on the GCN Radio Network.
All right, so enough freaking out about the Zika thing. The Zika thing's probably not going to get you. Let's go to Paul in New Jersey, who wants to talk about the economy. Welcome to the show, Paul. Hey, Paul.
The irony of basically free market capitalists complaining about the success of communist-run China. You know, the fact of the matter is China is really a capitalist wet dream come true. Let's be honest about that. American, so-called American corporations have taken the path of least social responsibility and decided to embark upon a large-scale program of sending what were American jobs that were well-paid and helped pay for the government and other social services and you know, public services. And they decided, the CEOs of these traitorous corporations, that they that all that mattered was profit. And so this process has been going on 30 years where they taken our industry and packed it up and shipped it over to China. And China has exploited that masterfully to their credit. And so here we're at a situation where this year's trade deficit was $350 billion in favor to China alone. And the establishment politicians, you know, they think this is all normal. They want to conserve that. And so that's why you see Trump and Bernie Sanders succeeding. The American people are disgusted with the traitors in Washington. And by the way, those traitors who passed these policies were not just, you know, traitor politicians. They were paid for by businesses. Such as,
that's right.
Such as the passing of the Affordable Care Act. That was passed, funded by insurance companies. And so here we go.
Same thing
again
with Obamacare. That was passed by insurance companies.
Right. And so we see this as the pathologies of capitalists themselves. It seems like they're...
Well, it's not capitalism, but keep going for a minute.
It is capitalism. It's libertarian.
No, it isn't.
Capitalism. Absolutely, because
no,
they have the freedom to pack their bags and go overseas looking for the cheapest market. This is an issue of nationalist economy or a globalist economy. That's what it comes down to. You can call it socialism or capitalism, blah, blah, blah. But to me, it's basically these capitalist companies looking to the bottom line, and they decided America doesn't matter, and we're packing our bags and going to China. And that's what's happened.
Let's just start with the fact that the definition, like you just said, you know, you're going to call it capitalist, but the definitions don't really matter. Well, I think the definitions do really matter, because when we have people who are voting or protesting or whatever they are doing, they're using these definitions. And what's happening is the antithesis of real free market capitalism. We are having these companies pay politicians, creating a fascist socialist system to create an advantageous environment for them alone, eliminating the competition, while at the same time circumventing the system that the rest of us would have to play by.
But this is all, these companies did this for who? For the shareholders.
Well, for themselves and the governments that have pension plans invested in them and the stockholders and all that sort of stuff. So,
but
these companies did it, so therefore business is bad or capitalism is bad, is ignorant. And you're too smart for that, Paul.
Yeah, but the reality is when IBM, is IBM publicly owned or is it privately owned?
It is publicly owned.
Is
by
IBM
shareholders.
IBM publicly owned? Or I, as a private citizen, can't go buy shares to IBM and that decide.
Sure, you can.
Okay. And the majority, you're saying that the majority of these companies that have done this, like Apple, you're claiming that the majority of the shareholders are public, the government buying those shares, or are these private individuals buying the shares to Apple?
No. I didn't claim either of those. That's just an assumption you're trying to put in there. What I said was these are publicly traded companies, right? These large companies are paying governments to allow them to have exactly what you pointed out, which are these advantageous situations that benefit them. Now, if you look at who owns these companies, they're publicly traded. So yes, you can go grab stock in them. And yes, if you have a government pension, your government pension is invested in them. If you have a federal pension, you are invested in Apple, you're invested in GE, you're invested in IBM. So yeah.
But it's still basically a cap. These companies are capitalists.
No, they're not.
To me, I just see it if they're...
That's what I said. To you. To you, they are. So that's what the listener has to realize. The listener has to realize that they need to not just say, okay, well, definitions don't matter, because, in fact, they do.
I understand that, but as I've said, these companies are privately owned by the shareholders. They're not run by the government.
So not privately owned.
They are not run by the government. You can't tell me...
No, they're not run by the government. Thank God. Okay, do you know how so worse the situation, Paul, would be if they were run by the government?
Right. Well,
you think it's bad now.
They are capitalist companies, therefore. They are not socialist companies.
What is capitalism? What is capitalism, Paul?
Capitalism is the private or individual's owning of businesses, not the government owning and controlling these businesses. As I've said, Apple...
So not these are not capitalist businesses, then?
What?
These are not capitalist businesses, then? Because you also pointed out just moments ago, Paul, that the government was getting paid off by these companies to create policy, right? I mean, that's what you were saying.
That's true.
Okay, so not capitalist, not free enterprise.
But these are, well, wait a minute, but they are free.
See, Paul, this is why definitions are extremely important.
I know, but listen, see, they're free enterprise.
No. Wait. It's my show. You're going to listen. Hold on. Nobody can hear you right now, Paul, so you can just talk ad nauseum. It's not going to help you. This is why it's important. It's important because you're going to have a young person out there listening, and they're going to say, oh, see, capitalism is the problem. This is why we need to have companies that are owned by the nation. This is why we need socialist forms of companies, because look at what IBM is doing. And they're going to ignorantly say, wow, that's true. Yeah, free enterprise is bad. Capitalism is bad. We need the government to own part of these companies so it has the interest of all. And in reality, it's going to create a worse system because they took what you said and said, well, see, Paul said it's capitalism. When in reality, it's not capitalism. It's fascist socialism. But you don't want to say that because somehow that then takes away the point of bad, bad, bad. You rich people, governments start owning part of the company. And that's what we can't accept, Paul. Now, I'm going to let you back on the air. You back?
Yeah, but this is a nationalist issue, as I said earlier.
You're trying to take nationalism because it's a belief that you have, especially based on your racial allegiances.
That national socialism. And by the way, when you were bad-mouthing
that's my point. You just proved my point.
Well, by the way, when you were bad-mouthing socialism in Europe before, let us remember, where are the immigrants going to? They're going
Europe?
To socialist Europe. Isn't that funny? If it's so undesirable and if socialism's so bad, why does the world...
No, because it's so weak. That's why they're going there. It's so weak. Crumbled. It's falling apart, Paul.
It's because of capitalist free market or free people buying into this idea of a concept nation where they allow...
Wait. Are you seriously trying to tell me? Are you seriously trying to tell me that Europe, the reason Europe fell in its socialism... is because they embraced free enterprise? That's what you're trying to sell me?
I'm saying just as in the United States, where they have powerful businesses that are traded on the bourge in the stock markets over there, they also have their wealthy people influencing the government, promoting the migration of people to Europe.
That's going to happen anywhere. That's why we need free enterprise to regulate that. Free enterprise, if the people have the power, Paul, then the people have. You don't want to have a small number of companies in bed with the powerful politicians creating some sort of socialist system that destroys people. That's just a bad, bad, bad place to be.
Right.
And Paul, thank you for calling in. I got to let you go. I'm at the end. But man, I look better every time you call, Paul. Keep going. All right. That does it for today, folks. We are out of time. Man, that is so much fun. It is so much fun. And it just goes to show how people have their definitions so wrong, and they want to keep them wrong because they want to keep believing what they think they want to believe. And the only people they're really hurting with those beliefs are themselves. All right, that does it for today. Remember, no victim, no crime. Look into jury nullification. Today, tomorrow, and as always, my friends, may your path lead to heaven and may freedom follow in your footsteps.
Hey, thanks for watching. If you loved what I had to say, then subscribe right here. If you hated what I had to say, subscribe right here. It's fun being mad on social media, isn't it? Either way, I'd love to hear from you. Send me an email right there.